What is going on, everybody? BrickBuilder here, and welcome to a brand new Fortnite video. Today we have a bit of a tutorial, bit of a gameplay. So if you guys do like that and want to see more of these like extended tutorials with like full gameplays, let me know by hitting that like button and commenting down below. Make sure to tap the subscribe button if you want to see daily gaming videos. Hit the bell so you never miss a video. But in today's video, we're playing 50v50 and we managed to get a high kill game, a really, really high kill game. So we're going to be talking a lot about tips and tricks to do that, as well as just commentating over the gameplay. Of course, this is a post commentary, although we do some live commentary stuff as well on the channel. But today we're talking about how to get a high kill game better. Now, we are doing this in 50v50, but I have gotten high kill games in squads, duos, and solos, etc. So this is just one example that I was recording, and we got a really high kill game, so I figured that'd be a good example. Even though the tips and tricks I share today are done in a 50v50 game, they'll work just fine in squads, duos, solos, etc. Now, obviously, the first tip is right now, if you want to get a high kill game, you need to go Tilted Towers, okay? That's an obvious tip, just because Tilted Towers is such a popular location on the map, it's one of the best spots to get kills. It's quite clear that this is probably the best location on the map if you're trying to get some kills. Because the big thing is you need to get early game kills. Now, as you can see, you gotta find people. We only looted one building, but once you loot that one building, you have to start moving. You cannot remain in one spot for too long early game, because you'll see in a second the kill count of total players left alive will go down, especially in duos, solos, and squads. In 50v50, there is a little bit more players that survive longer than average. And yes, that guy did just steal my shield, that little doodle banger right there. But yes, you need to keep on moving. You can't stay in one spot for really long because you want to get as many kills as you possibly can. So to do that, you really have to be moving, you have to be grooving, you got to be checking locations, etc. Now, if you are doing duos and squads, another high kill strategy you can do is, if you're both really good at the game, is to split up. In this game, we didn't really do that, but you definitely can, and the reason we didn't do that is because we had about 50 other teammates, so we didn't really have to do that, if that makes sense, because there was 50 of us, you know what I mean? But it can be effective to swap and split up locations, like one of you guys goes to one side of the map and the other goes to the other. That way you just have the most effective chance of running into people, if that makes any sort of sense. And I am about to get sniped. There we go. I just got shot down. And I was getting BM'd, but then Killer comes in and absolutely slays. But yes, you need to be going super aggressive on your kills if you want to get high kill games, especially when you have teammates or, you know, other enemies around you, because you need to snag all the kills you possibly can. You can't really give people any kills at all. You just need to take every single kill you can possibly get. And yes, I'm being revived. Perfect, because sometimes in 50v50, people don't revive their teammates. So when they do, it's glorious, okay? It's glorious. Now, let's go ahead and just edit out once we use our medkit, and boom, we'll hopefully get some more kills. Now, I only have one kill, but combined, we have a decent amount of kills so far, which I'm not going to complain, but the end game kills is really where it comes in for us as far as getting that high kill game goes. And I'm not going to complain, because this was a really, really intense ending for this game. Like, the end of this 50v50 match is probably one of the coolest endings ever. But yes, so as you can see, we're just moving and grooving. We're taking a chance to loot up a little bit here, because there is some loot that we're going to want, because you do need to have really good weapons and such if you're going to try to take out a high quantity of people. You want stuff you're comfortable with, guns you're good with, which is why, of course, I took the pump right there, because I'm better with a pump. It's probably the shotgun that I'm the best at, just because I've used it the most. But yes, so we're just going to keep moving, you know, always keep moving. And we see people shooting, so of course we're going to try to follow that, because you want to try to follow every kill you can. But then we see there's no one there, and we, of course, run away. But yes, also, as you can see, quickly farming up some mats there. You really want to know where quick mats can be, like, harvested. That's one of those spots. You really, really got to try to get any mats wherever you can. Just go for them right there. And okay, I got shredded, but I did a ton of damage, so it was worth it. Plus, we have teammates to help us out in this scenario. And it's all good, but yes, you do need to push your kills as we did there. Unfortunately, we pushed a little bit too much. We kind of got tunnel vision. We didn't realize there were other guys around there. In the future, I definitely should try to look around more. It'll definitely help a lot. And yes, we're getting revived yet again. And there's a mini on the ground, plus the one in our inventory. So that should be pretty, pretty helpful. Okay, like, now we're just going to, you know, get all organized on to that mini so we can grab it before they take it, because you never know. And we're just going to go ahead and use this right here. But yes, We are doing pretty well. I mean, as a squad, we're getting some pretty high kills so far. We're definitely, you know, on track to do good, okay? Because it's a lot easier to get high kill games when your early game is relatively good as well. You know what I mean? But as you can see, I've tried to take a snipe. It doesn't work. But there's four targets at least around here. That's a potential four kills. And Bogey on our squad manages to take one of those. I'm not even going to complain about that just because if anybody on the squad gets the kills, since, you know, it's squad that matters for high kill games in a 50v50, we're just going to take it and be happy and be satisfied with it. It doesn't really matter. I go ahead and get the snipe there as well. Works pretty, pretty nicely. And then we got another guy who I knock as well. Yet another kill. And they actually have some really good loot, the golden sniper. But I get sniped. I get sniped, which does kind of suck. But, you know, just crawling my way to victory. I got hit again. But again, I am safe. I'm secure. I am an independent man right now. I'm alive. Oh, I'm going to be revived soon. So I guess I'm really not that independent because I kind of depend on someone else to revive me. This guy literally used a mini in front of me and then just runs away or something. So I think things are going to go a little bit better once I get revived, of course. But yes, we have two kills so far, which is okay. It's not really that high kill. But the rest of our team has a lot more kills. Plus, the ending will get a lot, trust me. You're going to see. It will be a high kill game. It's a very high kill. We talk high kill games a lot, but this is, like, actually high kill. Like, 20-plus kill game. You're going to see. It's absolutely crazy. We have a chug jug, though, so thankfully, that should be good. Now, as you can see there, we're pushing a little bit more than we needed to. We didn't really need to push as aggressively as we were there, but, I mean, like, it really couldn't hurt in this case. It's just that this was late at night, and I wasn't exactly in my prime Fortnite capacity there, but as you can see, tons of kills so far. Can't even complain about it. Like, you just gotta be satisfied with that amount of kills right now, because that's pretty, pretty good. And, of course, we're gonna be keeping it up, getting more kills as the game progresses, especially with how aggressive we're playing. Plus, we're also getting a ton of loot along the way, and I get an elimination there. I do get hit already, and I see a ton of med kits, so I'm going to go run and try to grab those because I want to have a ton of healing. I also see a player, of course, back there, but they're not the top priority at the current moment. We got the organization of the, you know, the dual pistols, which, again, you want to take weapons you're good with. Dual pistols, I'm really good at, so I had to take them. Dual pistols are probably one of my favorite weapons in the game, for a lot of different reasons, because you can destroy bases, etc. But yeah, building here so we don't die from this player. And I spot them right across there, and I hit them right there with a snipe, so pretty good. Now, the key you can see here is sniping. Okay, you're going to see this throughout the gameplay, but sniping is really, really a prominent thing that's helping us get so many kills, because you can A, headshot someone with it, and boom, they're dead. Or just do a ton of damage and take off all their shield, which makes getting the kill when you get closer a lot easier. It's a general good strategy that I recommend using anyway, whether you're going for high kill or not. But just getting good at sniping so that way you can get more of these fantastic high kill games where, you know, you can't spend a lot of time on each kill because you have to keep moving and grooving. But pretty effective if you ask me, and it definitely works out very well if you're good at sniping. I'm not the best at it, but as you can see, I can hit some pretty good snipes in this gameplay. We get stink bombs, so of course we have to kind of make our way out of there, down to 45 health, so we're really, really low. Just gonna try again, but of course we keep getting shot. We can't even get this chug jug off, so we might actually beat DED right here, but we have four kills so far, which is enough that if everybody on the squad got four, we'd have 16, which is okay. That's not exactly the best kill game, but it's like okay. Plus, obviously, different players on the team are gonna get more than four, so you know, we should be good in that capacity. All right, we're gonna totally dip out of there again, and let's just go ahead and keep doing this thing here. Of course, I am telling my teammates that I need help and all that stuff during this time, because that is, of course, very important. But we are going to try to get the chug jug off here. We only have 11 health, so we are very, very low. And there's really not much I can do because I ran out of mats. So this person here is going to come in, and they're just going to BM me. Alrighty, I got BM, but that doesn't really matter because as long as the squad gets high kills, that's what matters. And as you can see here, killer already has 7. So between the two of us, that's 11 kills, which is pretty good, especially considering double bogeys kills haven't even been factored into that right there. So you got to, you know, add that as a thing. But as you can see, he's constantly moving. Killer's constantly moving, constantly trying to spot players. There's not a dull moment in his gameplay. He's not sitting still. You gotta be moving if you want to get these high kills. Goes for the snipe, misses it, but that's all right because it is a pretty good one regardless. And now he knows when to take out the scar to get that shield off just to kind of scare the enemies a bit. But you gotta be ready. Got another kill right there. Gorgeously just takes another kill, of course. So we're at 8. We're at 12 combined so far, which is pretty high kill if you ask me. Because as you can see, it's gonna get even better from there because there's a ton of players left alive so far. All right, there's one in the sky. He tries to do some shooting. Hits him a little bit, but not like a crazy amount. Doesn't really kill him in the sky. If he wanted to kill him, he probably should have went with a snipe, but the chances of sniping them would have been pretty rare anyway, so can't really blame him there. All right, as you can see, building's very good. You got to be able to build to defend shots because you don't want, and as you don't want to get shot. But as you can see, pushing this guy because he knows that other people are going to try to steal this kill, and he's just not about that life. So he turns the corner, sees like too many guys. Of course, he's not going to, you know, try to play too stupidly where he dies. So he does a little bit of a building. Unfortunately, loses some of those kills because he does that. But regardless, he does get really high kills, so I can't really complain. Plus, there's a guy on him now. Dude, the spray and pray strat jumps down a little bit. Gets a little bit of building off successfully, can chug some minis or something along those lines. Pretty valuable. And of course, Bogey there with his 5 kills as well. So a 17 kill game so far, and there's still a ton of players left. So it's only going to go up from here if you couldn't tell. All right, so now he's just doing a little peeking, you know, trying to find some enemies while, you know, in a safe environment. Because another thing people tend to do when they get these high kill games is a lot of players are really bad at what I call keeping momentum, which is being able to constantly play at a really high level. Like, a lot of players have bursts of like really good gameplay, and I'm that way, where I can get like some really good game kill, but then the next kill I get just sucks, you know what I mean? Or like I don't get the kill because of something stupid. So, you know, killer there was taking advantage of that because he knows maybe he's not exactly the most momentumist player. Generally, the momentum players, in my opinion, are like, you know, the esports professional people and stuff like that. They're just good at that naturally. Now, of course, you can learn that skill over time. But my point is he just took a little break there for like a short period of time, very short period of time, but just long enough. And he's doing that kind of again with the healing, just long enough that he can kind of like reload his stuff, get his grip, just kind of see what's going on, check the kills, etc. Things like that. Definitely useful tips right there. Now he sees a guy there is peeking, and he's going to try to go for them if he wants to. Did take the snipe, but unfortunately he kind of, you know, did something good there. We got 9 kills so far on the board from him, and we actually got another knock right there, so that's a casual 10 from him. As you can see, his snipes are on point. His sniping is really, really helping here as far as him getting more knocks, which will eventually turn into eliminations. Like, look at this. He's hitting snipe on snipe on snipe, guys. That's huge. As you can clearly see, killer's taking advantage of his skills, which are the most important thing you got to do. If you want to get high kill games, take whatever you're really skilled at and make that your focus. For him, it's clearly sniping. Sniping is clearly his strong suit. If you're better at shotgun fights or build fights, then constantly do those against players. But whatever you do, you need to do something that's quick and effective, which is why sniping is probably one of the best. Because, of course, sniping is super quick, it's super convenient, and you can do it from a very large distance. So you don't really have to worry too much about pushing. But yeah, so right now, 15 kills between killer and I, and then, you know, Bogey does get eliminated, but he does get a fair amount of kills before that, so we can't really argue too much there. Plus, I had to die before him, so yeah. Now we're just going ahead, and you know, he's trying to keep farming up, keep looting. He is looting, but you have to loot very, very quickly your kills. You don't have a ton of time to rest. That guy stole his med kit. All right, now killer's just looking for more kills. All right, he decides to meme over here, throw a little bit of C4 over there just because, you know, he's down to meme him. He's down to have less players on the team right now because he knows he's going to pull this victory, and he wants to successfully be able to get all the kills. And to do that, you sometimes have to do block off people and like prevent your teammates from getting kills if your goal is, of course, to be the highest kill player, which, of course, you know, killer was by far. Now he sees two people over here, and he just starts spraying at him. And honestly, it's his sprays are really good. Like, he's just naturally good at aiming, I mean, from his sniping ability and such. So there's that. Now, he's over there. He gets a knock with the C4. Pretty good stuff because C4 does a ton of damage and blows up structures. So he knows that would work very, very effectively right there. So now he's at 13 kills so far, and there's a few players left. There's not too many, so he does have to be quick here if he wants to make this game even more high kill, but it's already a 20-plus kill game right now. But he's going to keep it up because, you know, he wants to get even more, so he's going to keep pushing. He sees a guy up there. He's got 14. He sees him. He misses the snipe, unfortunately. Then he goes up. He goes up again. He misses the snipe. There's literally two guys left on their team. Is he going to get any more kills, or is 14 going to be it for killer? Crazy. Obviously, it's going to be insane. There's one more guy left. He just builds up. Got to play super aggressive at the end. He's playing super aggressive. He wants this kill. And there we go. He takes the kill. If you guys enjoy, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe, and I'll see you in another Fortnite tutorial.